What's up, everybody? Feels bad here. All right, and we are back. So, had a good start. I remember us being on a three-game win streak toward the end of the first month. However, we couldn't keep up pace. We started to lose a few games, and, you know, I'm almost tempted to change the lines a little bit, see who I want to, who likes to play with one another, and see if I can get this really going. I mean, Goudreau and Monahan are definitely going off, but as far as the rest of the team, they've been mediocre at best. And, you know, someone like Elias Lindholm, 23, doesn't have much time left. I almost want to push him. That's why I was thinking I want to put him on the first line and then have James the Real Deal Neal play on the second line. Hopefully bring up that scoring on the bottom line, and the bottom two lines are okay. Defensively, I mean, it has been pretty. Giordano likes to play with Brody. No, I think it's too soon to change the defense. Just curious for my own well-being. Okay, Mike Smith's been playing well, and Kari Lehtinen's been playing, I mean, like, not horrible, but backup numbers. Could be better, but, you know, he is our backup, so he's just better than Riddick or what we previously had. So, we are going to try the minor lineup tweak here, but I really don't think it should make that. I mean, it could make all the difference. Again, like, I just want Elias Lindholm to grow a little bit more before he gets out of that age bracket, because 23 is kind of where they start to stop growing, and if I can make him grow a little bit more, definitely help us out for the future. So we are going to be get right into it and start simming till February. What I'm going to do is I'll probably show you about half November, see how it's going. If anything interesting happens, I'll come back and talk about it, but I don't want to bore you with the slow sim that EA provides us with. Okay, so, another loss. We're still on that losing streak. I thought we would turn it around. Okay, all right. Okay, I pressed the button. Please stop. Okay, so, terrible start. I guess we have to go change the line changes again. I mean, I thought that putting Elias Lindholm up and James Real Deal Neal down would help, but I guess not. We could... You know, honestly, at this point, we should just try out something. Just try out something new and see if it works. Kind of just throw shit at the fan and see if it sticks. So, jeez Louise. Yeah, I mean, there's nothing more I could do for this team. I mean, again, I can move the defense, but I really don't think it's them. I mean, let me look. Oof. Okay, maybe it is that top line. So I would like to keep Noah Hanifin's top four. And Brody likes to play with Giordano. So I think I'm correct, right? Or is it Giordano likes to play with Brody? Yeah, Giordano likes to play with Brody. So we're going to put them together. Right hand shot, left hand shot. It really goes either way. I like to have left on left and right on right as far as their shooting hand goes. I feel like it's just easier to make passes throughout. It's just I really think this team could make the playoffs, and I don't. I mean, yes, we'd be better if we don't make the playoffs. We could potentially get another good player to definitely bolster this roster. However, I think we have a team now, and Mike Smith is not going to last forever, so I feel like we got to try to give it a go while Mike Smith is still here. I'm just going down to the trade deadline. But, yeah, we're gonna kind of go down to the trade deadline in this video, just because I think it's a good stopping point. Oh, my God, we're just getting lit up, but we are getting some more wins now, so maybe we'll be able to turn it around. No, but this is like, I feel like the game is just not as accurate as in real life because it's just like the players don't carry teams as much as they do in real life. So it's just like, for example, we have like Goudreau who's like been tearing it up. He won't carry the Flames in the game as much as he will in real life. So it's a little unfortunate, but we'll make do. No, I don't know why I would want to make that trade. Again, with the losing, you know, if it starts to continue to get to a point where we just keep losing, we might have to be looking to acquire more picks. And that'd be something I would do at the trade deadline. But no, it's just like we're one for one. Like I said in the last video, it's Calgary is a weird team to do because you can either go one for one or have a hot streak or a awful like losing streak. So it's really no like win two games, lose one. It's either like 1-1 hot streak or losing streak, which you could say for most teams, but that's just when I've done Calgary in the past, it's kind of been the case. I wish we had more like overtime slash shootout losses compared to just regulation losses because those just kill you. Hopefully the Pacific won't be as strong this year though. I don't think so. Vancouver doesn't become a powerhouse yet. So we should be okay as far as that goes. We might be able to squeak in, but I don't think we'll get in wild card. I think the Central's still pretty strong. So if we're gonna get in, we have to get into like that third spot in our in the Pacific Division. I kind of want to see where we're at. I think once, yeah, let's kind of want to see where we're at right now. See what we could do. We did start to win a few more games in January, which was nice. So the record a month before the trade deadline is 26, 21, and 4. I stand corrected. Johnny Gaudreau is hard carrying this team. But like I said, you know, it's a tight race, so that's it's all gonna be these like look, cap us, San Jose, Anaheim are all competing for that third spot. Cause I knew like in the Pacific it's 1 and 2 and then 3 is always up for grabs. And then yeah, like I said, like you look at the Central and it's just like the teams are a lot better there. I'm surprised Chicago's doing as well as they are, but they could always drop off. As far as points go, I know as we can see Johnny Gaudreau has 50 points in 51 games, which is stellar. Monahan not far behind. Elias Lindholm 34, 32. Matthew Tkachuk, I wish he was getting more. Feel like the third line here is getting destroyed with the plus minus. Backlund's doing okay. Hanifin. -7. Ugh. Where is Brody? Because I want to see how they've been doing. See, Brody is a +3, but Gino Giannis is a -7. So I really don't know what to expect, like what to think about that top line. Defensive pair that we changed. I mean, it's honestly all up in the air as far as what I should do. I feel like it's just the game's just going to take its course. However, is there anything I can do down here? -2, -4, -3. That is not good. But again, we don't have good depth to begin with. You are growing, even though you're a -9. So, I mean, I'll take it. Derek Ryan, -10, -8. So they are growing down there, even though they're just their plus minus is terrible. Feel like we might end Giordano's career early because of the plus minus. I mean, there's nothing really I could do. I mean, I don't really want to mess it up because, like, you can see the rest of the team is doing well, and Hanifin did grow. So we're gonna keep it like that. Mike Smith's not doing so hot, but Lettinen's doing better, and he actually grew in overall by 1, I believe. So this team is just—I really don't know what to expect. We could make the playoffs, we could not. We are in the third spot in the Pacific Division right now. Will that stay? I don't know. Let's get down to the trade deadline. But no, I don't do not want Mark Stahl, no, thank you. The second would kind of be nice. I kind of probably maybe would have done it for that, but Mark Stahl's contract is just awful for. It's basically dead money because he doesn't do anything. If you go on a little bit of a hot streak here, we definitely will be able to make the playoffs and make it a little bit interesting. We kind of see around the league who's giving up what, but then again, I don't want to really give up picks and prospects to get like rentals. I don't think we're that kind of team. We still have some more building to do, some more tweaking. Sorry, I was thirsty. But we're definitely not one of those for sure cup contenders to be going out and getting those rental players. I don't think it would be in our best interest. No, because we're just not that team yet. And I mean, like, we would be trading for players like James Avril Daniel. We wouldn't have him already the whole year. We would be the type of team to trade him away. So at the trade deadline, we are 32, 25, and 5. Johnny Gaudreau is still killing it. However, we are not in a playoff spot. It's frustrating, but I think this is where I'm going to leave it here. I just want to show you how everyone else is doing. All right, so Johnny Gaudreau obviously is doing insane. Monahan is close to following suit. Kachuk is doing well, even though he has 50 penalty minutes. He is the rat 2.0. He is a rat. He's the rat 2.0. James Avril Daniil doing good down there in the second line. Same as Backlund, 0 plus minus. I mean, like, it's better than the minuses they were before. I think they turned it around. Janikowski actually grew to an 80. Except this fourth line is atrocious, but what can you expect from this fourth line? Mark Giordano, you did bring up your plus minus. It was -7 at one point. Now it is only -4. TJ Brody, Hanifin grew, and now his plus minus, it used to be 0. Now it's +6. It's definitely good. Hamonic. Oh, right, we have you on the penalty kill. Our penalty kill is probably doing well. I'm actually curious to see that. I'll show you that too in this video. Mike Smith, though, I think it might be one of Mike Smith's last years. Definitely one of his last years, I think. And Kari Lehtinen, actually not a bad signing for 1 mil for 1 year. Definitely kind of keeps his team afloat. But I am curious to see how the team stats are. So we'll just look at the Pacific Division. Let's see, where is power play percentage? We're fourth at 19.1. It could be better. Oh, and our penalty kill is 81.9. I just want to see how that stacks up to the rest of our division. Fourth. So we're like right in the middle here. And that's kind of to be expected. Because, I mean, we're fourth in those stats, and we're also fourth on the point list. I don't know. I think this is. I'm going to leave you here. We're now a contender, which is nice. But I'm going to leave it here. Next video, we will do look around the league. I'll pre-scout and look and see if there's any sort of players that we might want to acquire. Again, I don't know if I really want to give up picks and prospects to acquire said players because I don't know if we're just not that type of team right now. But I'll do my due diligence and look. And then we'll go to the end of the season and we will see if we make the playoffs. So, signing off, this was Feels Bad Nation. Remember to like and subscribe if you want to. I'm not going to force you to do anything. And remember to have a few.